And coming up, Ayn Rand's epic novel, Atlas Shrugged, is now a movie. And the producer is here, and he's going to show you some of that movie next.
It's his own fault. He's not exactly open to competition.
A monopoly, to be exact.
We are working on a bill. It's called the Equalization of Opportunity. It proposes to limit the number of businesses that any one person owns to one business. However, we're going to need your help, Jimmy. We need you to grease the palms of your politicians in order to get the legislation we're spearheading passed.
The epic tome Atlas Shrugged, written by Ayn Rand, has inspired millions to believe that self-interest is in everyone's best interest. Now it's been made into a movie, as you just saw, that premieres, interestingly enough, on April 15th. With us now, the producer of the film, John Aglialoro. John, it's a pleasure. Welcome here.
Thank you.
Who is John Galt?
John Galt is what's happening. What's really the truth? I'm confused. And that's the exhortation. That's the claim that people say.
What's the big picture? What's the big story? What's the message in this movie? Many of us have read this book. It's 1,300 pages long. I read it in college, and I reread it a few years ago. And almost everyone who's read it has read it more than one time. What's its message?
The message is that you are in control of your own life, that rational self-interest is a virtue, that when you live for yourself and are responsible each and every day and take care of what your responsibilities are, you've done your part to help society.
What would Ayn Rand say if she were here today, where Jefferson's predictions have almost come true? On the long march of history, power of the government grows and liberty shrinks.
It's true, Judge. There's this eternal struggle we have where power and liberty are always at war, and we need to fight for liberty each and every day.
I remember as a college student, I came home from college one vacation. I started to tell you this during the break, and I left a paperback book on my nightstand, and it was a collection of Ayn Rand's essays called The Virtue of Selfishness. And my mother, who's watching us now, had a fit, saying, what do you mean, The Virtue of Selfishness? What kind of stuff are you reading at college?
Right.
I said, Ma, give me 2 minutes to explain. Explain to me The Virtue of Selfishness.
Well, when the alarm rings early in the morning, it's a responsibility of all of us to get up, get in the boat, and pull in the oar. You can go to the front of the boat, go to the back of the boat, but you got to pull the oar. It's your responsibility to be purposeful, to be gainfully involved in something that you love, and take care of you, and the rest will take care of itself.
Instead, we have a government that wants to take care of people in return for the people surrendering their freedom to the government.
Yeah, look at today's 8.8% unemployment rate. It's the government that says it's bailing out the private sector. It's the private sector bailing out the government with that number.
John Aglialoro, when and where can we see this movie, Atlas Shrugged?
April 15th. It'll open in about 200 theaters.
And this is part one. There's part two and part three coming for those who know the book.
Right. It's adapted faithfully, but 28% is part one, and we end it right about the end where it is in the book. And part two will be out next April 15th, and part three will be the April 15th after that.
Thank you very much for joining us. It's been a pleasure. Coming up, the plain truth on what happens when the government lies to you over and over again.